President Trump voiced support for implementing red flag laws in the aftermath of this weekend's shooting, but he made no mention of limiting or no mention of creating universal background checks, as he suggested on Twitter before the speech. Joining me now is Republican Congressman Rodney Davis of Illinois. For him, gun violence is no abstraction. He was at bat 2 years ago when a gunman opened fire on the Republican baseball team practicing for the annual congressional game. Congressman Davis, thank you very much for being with us this morning. We do appreciate your input. I know you've said that mass shootings are not just about guns. My question is, what role do you see guns playing in mass shootings?
Well, they play a very important role, as I witnessed myself when I and my colleagues had to run away from bullets on a baseball field from a crazed gunman who traveled halfway across the country and decided the way to affect his political grievances was to try and kill Republican members of Congress. But we also have to take a look at the root causes of what led that gentleman to leave Belleville, Illinois, come out to Washington, D.C., and decide to utilize a firearm to institute the terror that we all witnessed that day, that comes from the pure evil that someone who decides to fix their grievances by trying to kill others actually comes about doing.
Yeah, but how do you fix pure evil?
You know, that is a question that I think we have to all answer, and it's a question that we as members of Congress, both Republicans and Democrats, have to take a step back and say, are we going to focus only on one part of the equation, the firearm side? If that's the case, then we're not going to be able to talk about some of the positive things that we've done to already address what I would consider that pure evil. Many didn't know before the Parkland shooting that before I even got to Congress, the Cops Secure Our Schools program was defunded. I helped lead the efforts in a bipartisan way to refund that program. And now in school districts in throughout the nation and in my district, in the 13th District of Illinois, we have mental health professionals roaming the halls, helping our students deal with some of the mental health issues that they may be dealing with at their school, in their homes, or what have you. We also improved the Fix NICS program to help better background checks get taken place at federal firearms licensees. These are the things that we're doing right now, but we can certainly do more. I agree with the president. We ought to institute more red flag laws.
Mm-hmm. Red flag laws and the federal role in that only matters if the states have them. The federal government, some of the legislation now is for promoting or rewarding states that have them, but I know you're on that legislation and that's something you would support. You voted against in February the Democratic proposal, although 8 Republicans voted for it, to expand background checks, near universal background checks. In the wake of these 2 shootings this weekend, will you consider changing that vote?
Well, I would not consider changing the vote that I made, because that bill was nothing but a partisan show bill. That bill wouldn't have addressed the problems that we see with fixing what Democrats even call a loophole. In that bill, what we have to get to the point of is, in this country, federal firearms dealers have to provide a background check for anybody who's purchasing a gun. You cannot go online and purchase a firearm without having that gun shipped through a federal firearms licensee, and they will run a background check. Now, what many Democrats call the gun show loophole is actually a loophole that allows private sales. Now, to fix that, it would require a full gun registry. If I were to sell a 12-gauge shotgun to my nephew, that wouldn't be registered through a federal firearms licensee. It would take a full gun registry. Democrats aren't being serious. They didn't propose that in their bill.
Okay, but could you see supporting some kind of universal background check? And just on the gun show loophole, and the other reason on internet sales, yes. You know, above the board, internet sales has to go through a dealer with a background check. But if you go on the internet, sometimes you can find someone who will drive the gun to you and make the purchase person to person, which is not included in the background checks. There are ways around it. And part of the things these laws want to do is close those loopholes. So again, and I'm asking you because some Republicans, you know, Pat Toomey of Pennsylvania, other Republicans coming forward saying, put this to a vote. Would you consider more universal background check bill?
Well, I'm interested to see what the president and leaders in both sides of the House and the Senate, what they want to propose. I'm more than willing to debate issues that are going to make our community safer. But the problem is the bills that I've seen on the floor have done nothing but only further partisanship and not actually get to the root cause. And it's interesting, some of the comments that you made earlier about people avoiding the existing laws. We in Congress can't stop people from breaking the laws that we pass. But let's also make sure that the laws we pass don't only affect law-abiding citizens. You know, we have many communities, including certain neighborhoods in Chicago, in my home state, where, you know, killings each weekend are kind of ho-hum.
Yes.
That shouldn't be the case.
Absolutely.
Those people
absolutely
are not following the law
and handgun violence,
getting their firearms.
And handgun violence is something that needs to be addressed. Not so much the issue in the mass shootings. They're a little bit separate. I want to put up the picture of the weapon that was used, or the drum, the 100-round drum magazine that was used in Dayton. Why should there be legal protections for people to own this?
Well, I certainly don't know the answer to that. I certainly could be one that would be in favor of making sure that we limit capacities when you see something like that. But let's also not forget, we have to get to the root cause of what causes somebody to take a weapon, take that modification, and go out and kill people because they may be depressed or they may be angry.
Or they might be evil.
We need to come together.
Or they might be evil.
Or
they might want to kill people. And that might be the type of thing that is or isn't perceivable by mental health experts. I agree. You know, we need much more focus on mental health in this country. Everyone agrees on that. There is a question about whether mental health focus can stop every focus killing. But I do think it's interesting that you say you would be in favor of discussing a ban on high-capacity magazines, because that's an area, then, of agreement right there. There are Democrats I know who would love to get together with you on just that. Mayor Pete Buttigieg of South Bend, your neighbor, practically, was on TV earlier and said he would be in favor of, if all he could get was that, he would be in favor of that. So would you be willing to get together with Democrats and co-sponsor a bill to perhaps limit sales or ban sales of high-capacity magazines like that?
And like I said, I'm willing to discuss these issues. You know, President Trump has led the charge in banning bump stocks. I think President Trump is somebody who's going to help us lead the charge to make sure that we implement new red flag laws nationwide. Mayor Pete, he knows that the state of Indiana has a very good red flag program. And I would certainly hope in the plan that he mentioned today, just a few minutes ago, that a nationwide approach to what Indiana has ought to be acceptable to every other state. That's the type of bipartisanship that we need in this country. Look, I'm ranked the 50th most bipartisan member in Congress by the Lugar Center out of 435 members of the House. I certainly have a track record of working in a bipartisan way, but let's make sure we do it in a bipartisan way and not just turn this into a debate about the president and somehow him being at fault for what we saw in El Paso and what we saw in Dayton. That's tragic. No one person is at fault except the shooters.
No one person is at fault, but there's a lot that's been going on in this country to create the environment where this took place. I think everyone can agree on that. Congressman Rodney Davis of Illinois, thank you for being with us this morning. I appreciate it. Chris?
Look, it's not unusual to hear political responses to mass shootings. And there's a pattern, right? We're struck by the tragedy. There's a call to not see it happen again. And then it becomes a vacillating series of inactions. So let's talk with three mass shooting survivors about what they believe is a reasonable future for the rest.